Call it what you want. Climate change, climate crisis, the climate emergency. I like that one. It's dramatic, and it's a dramatic situation. Every year sees new records broken for heat, droughts, and wildfires. It's getting hot, girl, and not in a good way. And you might think, hey, but didn't all those world leaders get together in Paris ages ago and do something about this? Well, yes, in 2016, virtually all countries around the world committed to keep global warming to maximum 2 degrees increase, and even aimed to keep it below 1.5 degrees. Today, we're already at 1.1 degrees increase, so that's a big commitment.
Yay.
So, how are things going? Well, this line shows what would have happened without the Paris Agreement. Business as usual would have led us to about a 4-degree increase in temperature. Eek! Now, with all the emissions reduction goals countries committed to in the Paris Agreement, we're all good, right?
Wrong!
Even if we reach all the goals laid out in the agreement, which is not a given, we'd be looking at a 3-degree increase in temperature.
Also eek!
Our emissions are still up here, when they should be down here for the 2-degree target, and all the way down here for the safer target of 1.5. That's a big gap between where we are and where we need to be. And to add some extra drama, we have little time left to do all this in. We already emitted so much planet-warming carbon dioxide, especially the US, the EU, and recently China. We only have a tiny 5% of the carbon budget left before going over the 1.5 degree target, which at the current rate will be in 6 years from now. Now, I don't know about you, but thinking about trying to address this big global issue on a personal level makes me feel pretty overwhelmed, maybe even a little guilty. But every action, big or small, matters. Reduce, reuse, recycle, eat vegetarian, choose renewable energy providers, take the train, it all adds up. Know that what you do matters, but don't fall too deep into the pit of personal guilt that is the individual carbon footprint. With most of our emissions coming from the energy sector, it's big polluters like the fossil fuel industry and big corporations who contribute the most to climate change and have the biggest responsibility to reduce emissions. That kind of accountability is something they have successfully avoided to do to this day. On the upside, the fact that so few entities are responsible for so much of global pollution offers a simple solution. Hold them accountable and phase them out. As for the personal carbon footprint calculator, it was part of a marketing scheme paid for by oil company British Petroleum in the early 2000s to shift the blame of pollution and climate change away from them and onto individuals. Sneaky, sneaky oil companies. And that brings us back to what you can do. Of course, be as sustainable and as kind as you can be. But perhaps your most powerful weapon is your voice. Every additional voice, every colleague, acquaintance, or family member you talk to about climate change is another potential ally, voice, and voter. And voting is so important. Today, over 75% of Europeans believe their government is not doing enough to tackle climate change. Imagine what we can achieve when we mobilize all these people. We can push policymakers to hold big polluters accountable, phase out fossil fuels, ramp up renewables, and get us back on track to our 1.5 degree target. In conclusion, the story of climate change and emissions is complicated, but it's still possible to turn things around. Join the conversation, use your voice and your vote, and recruit more people to the cause. Together, we can make an impact. I feel like Oprah.
And you can make an impact.
You can make an impact.
And you can make an impact.
Next time on Days of Our Lives. So what can a country do to tackle the climate crisis? What's working well and what's not? Check out our next Infodrag video, where we talk about Germany's climate plans and massive renewable energy ramp up, and unpack topics like the heat and mobility transition, green hydrogen, and more. Listen up, my green-hearted glamazons. Infodrag is our runway revolution, twirling science into the spotlight to show off environmental enlightenment with a sparkle. Does it work for you? drop a comment below with your thoughts, questions, or even just a little bit of love for the series. And darlings, if our eco-extravaganza has lit a fire in your creator's heart, flaunt it, film it, and flash it our way. Make sure to tag us in your climate-conscious masterpiece. With a little bit of stardust and a little bit of luck, we might just sashay our way into more episodes for you eco-fierce folks out there.